Hello, everybody. My name is CJ Murphy from Total Performance Sports. We'd like to welcome you to the April 2009 exercise of the month, the tire flip. Tire flip is one of the greatest exercises that we have at our disposal for a lot of things, for strength development, for speed development, for conditioning. It's also one of the exercises that we most frequently see done incorrectly on a lot of online videos. Some of the mistakes we see in the tire flip are people moving very slowly, people lifting with a round back, people using straight arms to almost deadlift the tire up off the ground. We're going to show you in this video some of the wrong things that we've seen, and we're going to show you some of the right ways to do the exercise, a couple different variations. Incorporating the tire flip into your training program is something that takes a little bit of thought before you do it. Are you looking to develop maximum strength? You can use it as a substitute for a barbell exercise or a maximum method exercise. Are you looking to develop speed? You can use the tire on a dynamic day to help yourself get faster. Or are you looking to develop endurance? You can also use it for that. Once you've determined what it is that you want to achieve with this exercise, then it's up to you to choose an appropriately sized weighted tire for you to use. If you're interested in looking for how to choose a tire, you can go to elitefps.com and just do a search. There's an article on that site that I wrote on how to choose the appropriate sized tire for what it is you're looking to do. Right now, we're going to go on and we're going to show you the different ways to do the exercise, beginning with the incorrect way.
Okay, Steve DeLillo, my head strength coach, is going to demonstrate the improper way of flipping a tire. This way is frequently seen on a lot of online videos. Go ahead, Steve. We'll see what he does. He's going to have a round back, kind of a sumo stance, but he's moving kind of slow. All right, do it a little bit smoother. He's got those arms dead straight. What you see when you're flipping a tire this way is you've got a really increased chance of putting some strain on the bicep, maybe possibly popping a bicep. His back's really not in a good position. Okay, that's good, Steve. What we're going to do now is we're going to show you the proper setup and two different variations on how to flip the tire. So what we'll do is we're going to have Steve get down right now into the start position. He's going to get himself a little bit away from the tire, just far enough so that he can stay tucked in nice and tight. He's going to take his toes and he's going to turn his heels outwards a little bit with his weight is up on his toes right now. He's got a nice neutral back. You can try to arch the back if you want to. It's not really necessary. His arms are fairly straight. He's got a wide grip on the tire, and he's got his chest buried down on the tire as hard as he can. What he's going to do is he's going to drive as fast as he can and almost try to jump off the ground. On this variation, he's going to use a knee lift. Go ahead, Steve. And that knee drive will help get the tire over. Okay, he's going to reset again. He's going to try to do the knee lift again, but he's going to go very quick. He's going to go right into another rep right away. It's really cold out right now, so he's not moving too fast. All right, Steve, that's pretty good. Let's have him go back to the other side of the tire. Now he's going to do a series of three flips extremely fast. You'll see he hits triple extension of the ankle, knee, and hip. The knee drive is going to help get that tire over. It's not totally necessary to do that. It's kind of a natural movement. All right, and he's also going to transition under the tire after the triple extension and kind of catch it and push it over. Good. He's going to finish it. That drop right there, we call that finish, and he's going to push it hard. Good job, Steve. Okay, now Steve's going to show us how to do it without the knee drive. He's going to keep ground contact as long as he possibly can. And then he's going to actually leap off the ground. He's going to extend the ankles, knees, and hips really hard. He's going to leave the ground if he can. Whenever you're ready, Steve. And then right there, he's going to stop and catch. We're breaking the movement down so you can see how it's done. He wants to get a full jump off the ground, triple extension. Then he's going to drop back under it and then run it forward. Cut. All right, now Steve's going to show us how to do the same technique really fast. He's going to attack the tire between reps. We got to give Steve some credit. It's about 20 degrees outside today. You ready, Steve? Same exact technique. Triple extension. Drop under the tire. Run through it. Three times full speed. Go fast. You see he's actually leaving the ground and he's dropping under, transitioning properly. Great job, Steve.
Alright, so as you can see, we demonstrated a couple different ways that you can flip the tire properly. It's up to you to put into your program what you're looking to achieve with the exercise. We use a very light tire for demonstration purposes only. As I said, it's about 20 degrees out. So we didn't pull out a 650 or an 800 or a 900. If you are fairly strong, 650 to a 900 pound tire is a good tire for you to work with. If you're a big guy, if you're a small person, you might want to look at something in the 450 to 600 pound range. What you want to look at your program and think about is, if I'm doing this to build strength, okay, I'm going to be doing from say 1 to 6 reps as a general guideline. You want to use a tire that's going to be a challenge towards the end of that workout and not be a challenge towards your conditioning. If you're looking to improve your conditioning, obviously you're going to want to use, say, a lighter tire, which would be a lighter tire for you. There's no real way for me to make a recommendation on that because everybody's strength levels are different. But you're going to want to use a lighter tire that you can flip however many times you decide that you need to flip it, whether you're going for time, whether you're going for reps, it's up to you. And as far as doing dynamic work, whether doing speed work, you're going to be looking to do maybe 1 to 5 reps really, really, really fast. You're going to need to use a tire that's going to allow you to move at maximum speed throughout the entire range of each rep. If your speed drops off or your technique drops off when you're doing things to build speed, you should stop the drill and either choose a different rep scheme or choose a different tire. It's up to you. You can look at our website again. There's some pretty interesting tire flipping videos on there. We wouldn't say the technique is great, but they're pretty amusing. We have a guy flipping a 900-pound tire with a 650 stack on top of it. Some kind of circus tricks, which are pretty cool. Anybody has any questions on this, always feel free to email me. The email address is on the website. And stay tuned to our YouTube channel every month for a new Exercise of the Month video. Thank you.